afternoon students. Today we are going to continue the same chapter, symmetry and patterns, and today our topic is rotational symmetry. So when we are talking about rotational symmetry, first we should know about what is rotation. Rotation means when a figure is turned, a figure or a shape, it is turned in clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. So any figure you take, you can rotate it. Okay, like for example, I take this pencil box here. This pencil box, I can rotate it. You can see how it is changing. I can rotate it. This is which direction I have followed. This is clockwise. I can also rotate it in anti-clockwise direction in this way. Okay, now next is, what is the center of rotation? Any figure, when you rotate it, it is rotated through a fixed point. Like I have kept this, I am not displacing this pencil box from one position to another position. So just think that this point is sticked somewhere, it is stick, and then we are rotating it. Okay, so this kind of rotation where the figure or a shape is rotated around a fixed point, that is called as the center of rotation. Now we come to the next thing, that is order of rotation. What do you call as order of rotation? Now every figure or any shape, when they are completing a full turn means it is a 360 degree complete angle. How many times the figure comes to its original form? Means suppose I kept my box in this way. Suppose I have rotated it. This is by 90 degree. So the original form was like this, but now the form has changed. Once again I rotated it by 90 degree. So now it has come to its original form. Okay. So this is completed 180 degree. Another 90 degree. You see, it is not in its original form. Now another one, 90 degree, means at full turn, that is 360 degree, it is coming to its original form. So we can say the order of rotation of this particular shape is twice, because it is coming to its original form two times in the full turn, that is of 360 degree. So different figures or shapes have got different order of rotation. Some figures can have three order of rotation. Some figures can have two order of rotation. For example, when we take this what is this shape? It is a equilateral triangle. If you measure each vertex, at each vertex if you measure the angle, you will get it as 60 degree, and the sides are also equal. So this is a equilateral triangle. Now the question that comes to our mind is, what is the order of rotation of this particular shape? Suppose I turn it by 90 degree, is the shape coming to its original form? No. Here the vertices was in this way. Now the vertices has changed. Position has changed, you see. Next, if you see, I have tilted little slight. See, I have not tilted completely thing, but I have tilted it by 180 degree. So still it is not coming. So is there any order of rotation for this? Is this shape coming how many times? Now suppose you see 360 degree, it has got three line segments. If you divide 360 degree by 3, then what are we going to get? Answer is 120 degree. So suppose my shape is this, I change this shape by 120 degree, I have rotated this shape by 120 degree, then what I am getting? I am getting the same shape. Again I am rotating the figure by 120 degree, then again I am getting the same shape. Now how many times 120 degree comes in 360 degree? It is 3 times. So the order of rotation for a equilateral triangle has to be 3. Now look at this particular degree of rotations and what do you call it? Like for example, if we say 90 degree rotation, we say it as 1 by 4 turn, or we, that is quarter turn, because 90 degree is 1 fourth of 360 degree. Similarly, 180 degree turn is half turn, because 180 degree is half of 360 degree. 270 is 3 by 4 turn. Similarly, and 360 degree is the complete turn. So let us look at a particular shape. I have took a rectangle here. The rectangle, how does it look? Its original shape is this. Now when it is having going for 1 by 4 turn, it will look like this. When it is going for 3 by 4 turn, it will look like this. And when it will go for the complete turn, it will look like this. So I hope you have understood. Let us look at some other figures and understand the rotational symmetry. Now look at this particular figure. This particular figure on its original form, it looks like this. You can see the three points, corners points here, that is A, B and C, and these all axis, means it's a line of axis. Okay, it does not have any line of symmetry, but I am talking about the center or the fixed point. If you see here, then the fixed point, around the fixed point, if you will see the lines which is going, that is forming the three axes of this particular figure. Okay, so each of these two axes, they are maintaining an angle of 120 degree among themselves. So suppose you will put a turn, a quarter turn in this, so the figure will never look alike. Okay, because suppose I will make it, suppose I will make a 90 degree turn, how will it look? You see, the shape will come something like this. So now you tell me, is this shape matching with the original form? Just look at this shape and look at this. This is your A, B and C. So it is not matching, because here you see the line is taking an angle, here you see the line is straight. So it is, but it is not matching with the original form at all. Okay, so this is your quarter turn. But here you see, here at every 120 degree you are getting the same shape, the same form. Because it is having three axes, okay, which are at an angle of 120 degrees. So angle 120 degrees is fixed. So that means how many times 120 degree comes in 360 degree, we have to find out. So 120 degree into 3, 120 degree into 120 degree into 3 is equal to 360 degree. So if I will ask what is the order of rotation for this particular figure, then we can say, because 3 times the figure is coming in its original form in 360 degree. So we say order of rotation here is 3. Just like a triangle, here also the order of rotation is 3. Now everybody can look at this particular figure. How does this figure looks? The figure look like a flower, okay? And this flower has got how many petals? You can see this flower has got, this flower has got 5 petals. So you can see that this flower looks like a the shape, it looks like a pentagon only, a regular pentagon. Now what are the lines of symmetry for a regular pentagon? The same you will find here. So there are actually
5 lines of symmetry in a regular pentagon. Okay, 5 lines of symmetry. Okay, one side to the opposite vertex in this way. It's 3, 4, 5. This way. So 5 lines of symmetry is possible for a regular pentagon. So similarly, for a flower, for this flower which is having 5 petals, and it is also having 5 lines of symmetry. Now the question is, what is the angle between each axis? For this, what you have to do, the complete rotation we take it as 360 degree, and because there are 5 lines of symmetry, so divide it by 5. So what are we going to get? 5 7s are 35, 1 2 1 0 5 2s are 10, so we get how much? 72 degree. So between two lines the angle is 72 degree. This means this flower will look alike only when you turn it by 72 degree. By each 72 degree turn, this flower will look the same as it is. Okay. Now the question is, how many 72 degree comes in 360 degree? So that is 5 times. So the order of rotation for this figure will be, order of rotation for this figure will be 5. Now we come to another, the last form of symmetry, that is called translational symmetry. This is another way in which we can move a particular shape. So translation symmetry, what do you mean by this type of symmetry? So every point in a particular figure, it is moved by us by the same distance and in a specific direction along a straight line. So what, so like for example, I have a drawing here. This is a figure here. Okay, I have named two points A and B of this figure. Now this A is sliding or translating to this point, that is A dash. B is again moving to a point, that is B dash. So you see the figure entirely is moving, but each and every point of the figure is moved by the same distance. Like for example, if we measure the distance between A and A dash, it is same as the distance between B and B dash. So this is what we call it as translational or translation symmetry. This kind of symmetry is also known as sliding symmetry. We also call it as sliding symmetry. So I hope this is clear to everyone. Now let us look at this question. This is a practice question which is given to you. Achha, before that, let me tell you about example 1 in this book. So here you can see the question, that is, it is showing you the letter A that appears same as its original position only after a complete turn, whereas letter H appears same 2 times during a full rotation. So here you can see letter A, this is the original shape. After 1 by 4 turn, that is 90 degree turn, it looks like this. After another 90 degree turn, that is 180 degree total, it looks like this. 3 by 4 turn, it looks like this. And full turn again gives the same alphabet A in its original form. So one thing we have come here to the conclusion, that every shape fits onto itself after a full turn of 360 degree. Okay, any shape you see after 360 degree turn, it will definitely come to its full shape. So that is why we don't consider the full turn as the means it is
it means that the shape does not have any rotational symmetry. There is no order of symmetry in that particular shape. Okay, so now you see here, because here letter H is coming how many times in the total, means from original shape up till full turn, how many times it is coming to its original shape. Now, so we found out that at 180 degree, that is half turn, it is coming to its original shape, and second time it is coming in full turn. So total, the order of symmetry for this will be, order of rotational symmetry will be 2 for this particular shape. Now let us look at the question here from practice. Show step by step that letter I appears same 2 times during a full turn of 360 degree. See, this is our letter I. As you can see, this is our letter I. Now this I, when you will go for a half turn, 1 by 4 turn, it looks like this. This is 1 by 4 turn. Next is when letter I will go for half turn, it will look like this. Then you have, then when it will go for another 1 by 4, that is 3 by 4 turn, so it will look like this. So this is 3 by 4 turn. Then the final thing that will come here is the full turn here, and it looks exactly same as the original one. So you can see that 2 times I letter has appeared in the full turn of 360 degree. So the order of rotation, order of rotation for letter I equal to 2. Let us come to the question from exercise 12A. Rotate the shape, draw shapes on graph paper, and then show rotation. Now let us come to question number 2 from your book. Here it is asking about how many lines of symmetry and how many times the shape appears the same during a complete turn. That means it is asking about the order of rotation here. So as you can see, this is letter Z. Letter Z does not have any line of symmetry. So we wrote 0 over here, and also it does not show any means in the total 360 degree. Only at 360, after complete turn only it is showing it will come to its original shape, which is not counted as order of rotation. So we write 0 over here. The same is with this particular figure also, it does not have any line of symmetry. So 0 0. Let us come to the next figure. It is a square. A square, you know, it is having a 4 line of symmetry. That's what we have written. And along its line of symmetry only, if it is rotated, like 90 degree angle, if you will rotate, then you will get the same figure again. So it is total having 4 order of rotations. Now let us come to this particular floral pattern. So this is also showing a 4 line of symmetry and 4 order of rotation. Let us come to the next question. This is question number 3 over here. It is showing letter S. Now you see original shape of letter S is this. Now where we are getting this? Only in 2 instances. Last one is there, and also this second one, that is doing 180 degree turn. So we are putting in on this. So these instances are only matching with the original shape. Let us come to the next question. We have already read about translation symmetry. So this is actually showing the translations patterns. You can see the P slided, and here you see fish is again slided to equal distance from the previous P fish. Okay, so this is this. Both the figures are showing translation. Both the figures over here sorry, both the figures over here, this is it is showing you translations. Let us come to patterns with reflections. Okay, in patterns with reflections, as you can see, here this P and this P, they both are actually rotated. This P we got after rotating the rotation of the first P. So these two are again getting repeated and forming the pattern. Similarly, this particular shape also, it is a this kind of shape is having two lines of symmetry. So here you see the mirror image is quite alike. The reflections are also same as the object. So everywhere we are getting the same. Let us come to the next question, that is pattern. Next one, that is pattern with rotation. You see here the first P and the second P. So this second P is found by the rotating first P. Again, same way. So everywhere it is showing the pattern with rotations of the same letter P. Here also the shape is triangle, triangle, different forms of rotation, how it looks, it is given here. Let us come to example number 2. Use the shape. This is a right angled triangle shape to create a pattern using sliding, reflection and rotation. By sliding means you have to just repeat the shape, but you have to keep equal distance between each and every shape. And using reflection, you have to just show the how it is reflected, like by 90 degree turn or by 180 degree turn, how will it look. Same pattern you have to follow. Next is using rotation. Using reflection means you have to show the mirror image of this particular shape. So each shape, how will the mirror image look, this you have to show here. Using rotation means here you have to see how by turning in some angle how the shape will look. So the image and the object both are forming a pattern here. Now let us come to this one, patterns by combination of translation, reflection and rotation. So if we see carefully at this particular shape, so here you can see this particular one tile is shows the repeated, this particular tile is getting repeated to form the pattern. So this is just showing the rotation of F, and also it is telling, it is showing the sliding of the tile. Okay, from the sliding, the entire tile is getting slided and it is forming the pattern. The same thing here, this particular square box is getting slided, but what is the particular square box showing? It is showing the rotation of P. So here it is showing both your rotation as well as translation symmetry. Next question is bit C. You can see here again this particular tile is getting repeated here also, letter P. It is here it is showing reflection, is the this P and this P, what does it show? This both are showing reflection, and also it is showing sliding because the entire tile is getting slided. And it also showing a rotation, how? Because this particular shape is getting rotated in this way. Again in this way. Okay, so rotation, reflection and sliding. All the three combination pattern is this. Let us come to exercise 12B. Create patterns or borders using the first letter of your name. Okay, so this is up to like you can, I have my first letter is N. So using N I can form so many patterns. I can take the mirror image of letter N in letter N. How will it look? How letter N will look mirror image? Somewhat it will look like this. Okay. So both of this, it can form one tile and it can, you can repeat it so many times and it will show a pattern. Like the previous questions, you can see in this way you have to create in this way. Then use a rectangle, star and allow to create different patterns. Then create a tile using reflection and repeat it to create a pattern. Any tile you make using reflection. Using reflection, just now we saw P and P. Similarly, you can use any other, let's suppose F and this F. These both are showing reflection. So you can repeat this tile and form a pattern. Create a tile using reflection rotation. Means the tile should show both the things, reflection as well as rotation. Okay, so in this way, we have completed exercise 12A and 12B. You have to do the exercise questions as well as the content of the images in your geometry notebook very neatly. This question, you have to use a graph paper. I told you graph paper is available in market. Only for this question, you have to use it. Graph paper, and you can paste it along with the geometry notebook. Okay, thank you.